Greetings and welcome to this week's Prime Insight. My name is Gavin Gooden. I'm the Marketing Director here at BlastOne. Today our topic is ventilation, and by the end of this video, you not only understand the four principles and the three rules of effective ventilation, but you'll also be armed with insights on how to ventilate a single entrance enclosure, such as a tank with a solitary manhole as your only egress. So let's get into it. First, here are four general principles for any proper ventilation system. First principle, good ventilation helps maintain air quality within the breathing air zone of the operator down to a point that allows the operator's respirator to effectively deal with any remaining atmospheric contaminants. Second principle, good ventilation helps maintain good visibility by extracting the dust and allows the light to illuminate the work area. The third principle is good ventilation brings in fresh air which will dilute any contaminants in the work area, preventing it from reaching an explosive level. Of course, always use gas monitors. Principle 4, good ventilation also protects against noxious dust or lead contaminants from escaping the blasting enclosure and polluting your external environment. Unfortunately, many contractors consider ventilation to simply be a compliance cost, when in truth, ventilation pays for itself by having a safer and more productive work environment. Next, here are the three rules to follow when you're designing your ventilation system. The first rule is air should always be brought in high and extracted low. The reason for this is twofold. First, solvent fumes and dust are heavier than air, and high to low extraction utilizes gravity and assists with air removal. And secondly, this helps limit the exposure of these contaminants in the breathing air zone for your operators. Ventilating upwards will naturally lift contaminants and increase odds of compromising your PPE and your equipment or the vision of your operators. The second rule is the system needs to deliver the correct airflow to achieve your correct number of air changes. This is measured in changes per hour or air velocity through your work area. And this airflow depends on three different factors. The first is the type of contaminants you're discharging. The second is the type of work you're doing. And the third is the size of the space. And if you've got a work area which is encapsulated, you should make the cross-sectional area as small as possible. You should always seek a specialist's advice to help calculate the project factors that you have to deal with and establish the correct airflow and the number of air changes you need. Never guess. Always consult an experienced professional. And finally, hazardous dust and or fumes need to be properly captured or exhausted to safely comply with any environmental or OSHA regulations. So each of these principles seems easy to accomplish until you meet those real-world conditions which contractors meet. And this leads us into our all-too-common scenario. How do we effectively ventilate a tank with a single manhole opening at the top? Obviously, due to this setup, principles 1 to 3 are naturally compromised, and this scenario is quite common for our industry. So here's a workaround that we can recommend. But this tip is general information, so please confirm with an expert before implementing this strategy on your project. The first thing is simple. Use a duck saddle that employs a pinch funnel section to prevent obstructing the manhole. This duck saddle will allow workers and will give them the ability to enter and exit the manhole without any difficulty. Then make sure the ducting is long enough to run from the manhole to the lowest possible point in the far back corner within the tank. And if you're coating the tank, string a cable from the manhole to the attachment in the far back corner and clip the ducting to the cable to keep it off the floor. So what's the most common mistake we see in the field? Often the ducting only extends slightly into the tank, below the mouth of the manhole and into the upper regions. But when your ventilation method employs positive pressure, that's blowing air, it simply circulates the dust and the vapors due to the constant downward pressure. Some dust will exit, but the concentration of dust will build. When your ventilation method employs negative pressure, as in vacuum extraction, the ducting, although effective in the utmost levels of the tank, it isn't effectively drawing the heavy dust and the gases that gravity concentrates towards the bottom of the tank. However, if you implement our strategy and the ducting is taken to the far back corner of that tank, it will effectively draw the dust away from the operator and extracts the air through the ducting. Again, these suggestions are general workaround tactics, just to give you an overview of how to mediate dust in a single entrance tank project. However, we strongly suggest seeking experienced specialists to assist with your specific situation. Thank you for watching this week's Problem Insight. We'll see you next week.